hundreds of people are using New Hampshire's auto registration process to cheat the system of hundreds of thousands of dollars. Massachusetts officials catch more than 200 people each month illegally registering their cars in New Hampshire. Maine has similar initiatives.
We're finding people register their car based on a post office box that they purchased, based on a neighbor's address, some empty lot.
Here's a New Hampshire car.
In Lawrence, Massachusetts, police officers patrol looking for local residents who have New Hampshire plates on their cars.
Vehicles are supposedly it's registered in Nashville, New Hampshire. But as you can see, she lives right here.
This woman tries to say she just moved, but a special patrol has been documenting how long her car has been parked in front of this apartment. If cops spot it on 30 separate days, they can tow it from a city street. The fine, up to $1,000.
The vehicle's registered in New Hampshire.
Yes.
All right, you told me you lived in New Hampshire, and then you told me that that wasn't true.
Why do people do it? By registering in the Granite State, Massachusetts drivers avoid paying an excise tax, 5% of the car's value. And some aren't required to carry insurance. It could be up to $3,000 cheaper to pretend to be from New Hampshire. Lawrence police say the crackdown began because residents were furious that their neighbors were cheating the system.
In the beginning, it was easy because we knew where they were.
Right.
And the neighbors knew, and the neighbors were just giving us information.
Despite the extra registration money they get, New Hampshire authorities do not consider it a windfall. They say when mass commuters with New Hampshire plates get into accidents, it drives up insurance rates for legitimate Granite State drivers. Investigators on both sides of the border have created a task force to address the problem.
That's the reason that New Hampshire consumers should all care, because they need to be paying auto insurance based on New Hampshire accidents.
Authorities give plenty of warnings before impounding vehicles. Cars that are under surveillance get a warning sticker urging the owner to properly register it. There are cases when out-of-state cars are legitimately kept in Massachusetts, as with a live-in caregiver. Police say it doesn't matter if you own property here or have family here, only where the car is parked each night.
In 4 years, we probably have cited about 800 people. We probably have towed about 300 cars.
Bay State cops also notify the New Hampshire DMV. Authorities here then prepare more charges against the accused for falsifying their residency.
New Hampshire DMV is actively involved in investigating these crimes. What's important for you to understand is that residency is actually established by towns and cities and not the DMV.
You don't live in New Hampshire. You live here on Newberry Street. Do you see what I'm saying?
Before this car is towed, the owners take out all their possessions. Police believe they decided it's too expensive to pay the fines and register it too. So they might never claim the car, abandoning it and its New Hampshire license plates too. The operations work so well that police in Lowell and Haverhill have begun similar programs. There's also the risk of jail time for some. About 200 people have been charged with insurance fraud when they allegedly lied in a claim about living in New Hampshire.